What's up? JJP in the house. Today's my birthday. Well, actually, it was my birthday yesterday, but today is my birthday in America. And I want to thank everyone who sent me birthday wishes. Thank you very much. They are very appreciated. I hope all of you are doing very well. I hope things in your lives are well. And if there are not, things can get better. Sorry, I was eating some grapes and I guess some of the juice went down the wrong pipe. But I'm 52 years old now. Life has gone by really, really quick. It's been like 10 years since I think I first started YouTube and maybe my first videos talking about Japan and bringing it real to you from the streets. It's gone by really fast. I'd like to thank all of the people, and I have quite a few people who contact me from all cultures, different cultures, black, white, Asians, different countries and things. A lot of people have emailed me and I've responded. Hopefully I've responded to everyone. I try to do that. I believe that's very important. I really appreciate all of you who I grew up with, family, friends, different states, neighborhoods. It's really great to talk to your parents, get to know you. Thanks for inviting me to your homes, getting to know your parents. I learned a lot from them. Sorry about that. I learned a lot from them. And of course, I should make the video when I'm not coughing, but when I'm moving, my mind relaxes and I'm able to really get out what I want to say and things come streaming to my mind and just blah, blah, blah. I'd like to thank all the other people who I've met in my travels. I really want to thanks for all the people who watched my videos. Those who support, those who hate it, you know, I still got paid, so gotta be grateful. I'd like to thank all the people who, and I don't want to say brothers, but not only brothers, but white people and Asians and different people from around the world who actually changed their lives because of my videos. A lot of guys, women too, did better in school, you know, from junior high school and high school, went on to get degrees, moved on to do better in life, and I really want to say thank you for taking the time to listen to the words I said, and it's nothing new what I've said. They, you know, I don't say anything different than your parents. I think the only difference is probably maybe I attached something to it. You know, like, so for some of the guys, it might be a Japanese face or just being in Japan or talking to people, just driving around. You know, there's a goal, you know, that was attached to it that that could have been what made the difference. But I'd like to thank you for those views and doing better, because actually I'm not really good at when people, you know, say thank you for things and compliment me. I'm not really good with responses, so that's why now I'm just saying thank you or thank you very much. I think that's probably appropriate, because when I try to expand on it, sometimes I mess up. But I've had a lot of people from the beginning who used to call me their hero, and I would say I'm not their hero. And there is a reason to it as why I did that. But, and the reason is, is because actually I really didn't do anything that, like I said before, that your parents didn't do or didn't say, or other people didn't say, your teachers didn't say. I think probably, if anything, that I've done that was probably different, other than attaching a different face and bringing, actually being in another country, was probably letting or reminding you or bringing to your knowledge or to your, not to your knowledge, to your recognition, or however you want to say it, that everything that you're studying in school has an English word, or whatever word is a word. So when you see the equation 3 times 5, well, actually, that is a sentence, T-H-R-E-E, blah, 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 with a period. And the only problems that you have in school is that you just don't understand the vocabulary, the definition of the word, because the definition of a word carries meanings, instructions, and things like that. And once you understand the meaning of a word, then how would you not understand? It's like you get a book talking about thermodynamics or quantum physics or whatever, and if you read the whole book and you understand it, and if you understood the definition of every word that was in that book, then what part of that book would you not understand? So basically, that is probably one of the things that maybe I stressed. If you don't understand, then look in the dictionary. But other than that, I really didn't do anything that your parents didn't do. And I think that's one reason why I don't really try to take credit for my videos, or when people say I'm their hero, I say no, I'm not, you know, and I reverse and say no, you're my hero, because a lot of you have actually took the words that I've said and used them and got degrees and became successful and things like that. And that's great, you know. I don't envy anyone, but you know, I would like to have that a lot of experiences that other people have. But don't get me wrong, I've experienced a lot of things too. So I could have went to, you know, to a university, you know, got degrees and everything, but I'm definitely sure I wouldn't have experienced what I experienced in my life. Definitely wouldn't have came to Japan. That would have been that. If I would have went to college, I would have definitely not stepped foot in Japan, because I wasn't thinking about actually traveling to Japan or anything. I was thinking about more go to Europe, go to Spain and stuff like that, because most of my friends that I associated were, well, not most of them, but a lot of them were from Europe and stuff like that. And I was really interested in it. But I really want to thank a lot of the brothers who actually took the time to do better, took the time to make plans to come to Japan, to actually meet me, you know, and we went out and partied. I mean, like, a lot of times we meet up, a lot of us, you know, a lot of people say they expect to go out and party, but once we meet up, a lot of them, when we go to the clubs, actually we just sit down and chat, you know, we really do, just sit down and talk, and it might be sometimes about the women, but it's really about life and you know, how different things are, you know, being in Japan and being in the United States. So that's a lot of that's what we talk about. Some of the guys, yeah, basically that's it. Or we go to different places, but when we hit up the clubs, though, if they are trying to talk to women or anything, usually I'm just chilling by myself and they off doing what they doing, you know. So it's not, how can I say, it's not what a lot of people expect it to be when they come, you know. They say, oh, let's go do this, let's go. I'm like, okay, you know, but I already know what's gonna happen. We get go to the club, you know, everybody does do what they do in the clubs, and or just go and walk around and chat, go get something to eat and chat, and that's fun. I want to thank a whole bunch of you who are not brothers. Well, I wouldn't say not brothers, that's stupid. But other people from other cultures and stuff. One guy named, I think his name is Ricky. He's from Italy. He was real cool. Well, man, I'm actually, I was walking in the street, and since I bought you, he walked up to me, you GS250 JPN? I said, yeah. Oh, I'm Ricky, blah, blah, blah. But what happened was he did email me and say he wanted to meet because he was already here, but we never got in contact, but we ran into each other, I think like three or four times in Osaka, which was cool. You know, he's a cool person. Other brothers, other white people, Asian people that I've met just walking on the street. One guy, what's his name? I want to say Vaughn. It's not Vaughn. Gosh, he's from Vietnam. I can't think of his name. I made a video, and me and him met in Nada. That was weird, because not weird, but it was different because I was walking in the street and walked past a billboard, a stop sign, a bus stop, and I just saw him and his friends walk by, and you know, I didn't know him or anything, and I wasn't even paying attention, and I just happened to look down and his feet stopped, and I was like, huh? And then he backed up. You just GSD50? I'm like, yeah. So Nate, that's his name. Nate, I think it's Nate. And I think it was Nate, starts with an N or something like that. And we made a video, that was really cool. This one sister, I think she's from Texas or Tennessee. I was walking in Osaka and she walked down the street and I saw her and said, hey, how you doing? Because every time I see black women, I always sometimes I'll drive and park somewhere real quick or run 2 or 3 blocks, you know. Hopefully I can catch him just to say hi, and I've done it quite a few times. And I said, hey, how you doing? What's your name? You know, every time I see sisters, I always say hi. She looked at me, are you GS250? I'm like, yeah. She said, oh, I watch your videos. It's because of you I came out here. You know, she came out by herself, and, you know, she did well, you know. I'm not going to tell you all her business and stuff, but it was really nice, you know, to meet her and a lot of other people. Some brothers come out here, you know, and they're like, I'm going to meet you. And I'm like, all right, you know, this is my brother from Canada. And I wasn't upset or anything, you know, people are going to do what they're going to do. And he said, hey, let's meet. So I'm, you know, looking forward to meeting him. And all of a sudden, some unexpected positive things happened, and we didn't get to meet. You know, he was kind of sad, but I was like, no, it's okay, you know. I want to tell the story, but I can't. If he gave me the permission, gives me permission, then I'll tell you guys. I mean, from my point of view, because... It's funny. It actually is funny. Because it's something I tell a lot of guys all the time anyway, and they don't believe in them. When they come out here and it happens, then later on, like, oh, okay, now I understand what you're saying. You know, we just laugh about it. But, yeah, it's really interesting. A couple of brothers, they live in different, like one brother, he lives out in Nagoya. A couple of brothers, someone up there to visit them. And it's a lot of people up in Tokyo, actually, who are the players group. My players group. You guys join it if you want. ID is online, GS350JPN. And I do actually want to go up there and visit them and stuff like that. But it's because we do a lot of talking and stuff, you know. And it's interesting. It's really interesting. But, I want to really thank all of you because these videos that I made weren't made in vain, you know. And actually, I just got started. I just bought a camera one day. Me and Ron was hanging out. Always had my computer with me and always messing around with it. Never really got professional on it or anything, but you know, I always had it. I guess I was making my, what else things called, my English classes thing, lessons for my English class and stuff, so I always kept it with me. But it's interesting, the last person I met was a guy named Rich, and recently from Chicago, and he was cool, real cool. I things happened. I had just met him, like, it was like he was still here, and I was like, oh man, I'm sorry. So I just grabbed my car and just ran up and see him. You know, we hung out. be him and the guy called Fox. Fox is funny. I met him last year at a Hanami in Osaka Park. And some other brothers have met. But, yeah, it's interesting, you know, to meet people and stuff, meet some other YouTubers and things, and it's and I mean, you know, it's how can I say? I want to say pleasing. I don't know if that's appropriate or not, but it's, I guess, satisfactory or something like that, because or satisfying, because it's just interesting just to see all these brothers. I don't know how many brothers I've met over the years. I'm thinking at least 500, but it could be 300 to 500. But for sure, I've met a lot. I mean, when I say brothers, it's everybody. Okay, I'll just, from the end of this video, brothers means everyone. And it must have been about anywhere between 300 to 500 people, and still keep in contact with a lot of people, which is cool. You know, and it's interesting. 10 years. I think I'll cut this short. I don't want to run off at the mouth on the thank you video too much. I don't want to say too much. I mean, I don't want to get off topic. I usually do that. But yeah, I want to thank everyone for the birthday wishes. I got a letter even from Lexus too. And all of you out there, just do well. Life is really, really simpler than we really think it is. Continue to prosper, eat well, sleep well, work well, study smart. See you in my next video. Peace.